सूरज की पहली किरण के साथ दिन की शुरुआत कीजिए। सुबह का मंगल प्रभात आपको शुभ हो। सुबह सुबह हो खुशियों का मेला, ना लोगों की परवाह ना दुनिया का झमेला, पंछियों का संगीत हो और मौसम अलबेला, मुबारक हो आपको ये खूबसूरत सवेरा।
हर सोमवार से लेकर शुक्रवार तक सुबह 6 से लेकर 9 बजे तक शामिल रहे रेडियो फिजिटो पर हम सफर में रविंद्र सिंह के साथ।
Nimbula, ayo Mr. Ben.
Ella ba?
Na magi kiro menor kine dio vi mata ka moni chi kine fo rumbuka.
Ella bula FM. Na we do have a shilling.
On FBC News tonight, Bar retains BOG title. 15 necessary buses allowed back on the road. And floodgates to reduce threats of flooding. Good evening, I'm Amrita Priyadarshini and you're with FBC News. Bar has retained the Battle of the Giants title after beating Lotoka 3-1 this afternoon. Lotoka scored first early in the first half, but the men in black took over the show and never looked back. Bar's goals were scored by Ronil Kumar, Avinesh Swami and Osea Vakatalesau, while Lotoka's lone goal came from the boots of Elvin Avinesh. Stay with us, we'll have all the action from that final in our sports segment later in the bulletin. A 33-year-old school teacher of Senganga is the latest road victim. Police say he was hit by a twin cab driven by a 30-year-old of Natua housing while crossing the road with his bullocks. The victim was taken to the Lambasa hospital by police but was pronounced dead on arrival. The driver of the vehicle is in police custody. The Land Transport Authority has made its stand clear. The audit of the Nesese Bus Company Limited fleet will not be rushed. LTO CEO Nesatuina Deva made the statement as 15 of the 32 buses that were grounded last week resumed services today. Roland Koroy reports.
Day 3 into the grounding of the fleet of the Nesese Bus Company and just 15 buses have been allowed back on the road. The bus company may have already lost a substantial amount of money from this grounding, but according to the LTA, safety comes first.
What really is important at this stage is not rushing through the audit, it's not getting these buses so quickly back on the road. What we have been trying to check on for the last couple of days on our series of meetings with the Fiji Bus Operators Association and the directors of the necessary buses, the system that will take care of these buses as soon as we release them.
Nesatuina Deva says the LTA will continue to monitor the bus company.
Our greatest concern now is the maintenance system they will be using to look after their buses, to ensure the safety and the conditions of these buses, or the fitness of these buses, are maintained, you know, on a daily basis.
The LTA CEO has also acknowledged the cooperation by the bus company.
They have already confirmed and committed that they are going to get their QAMS, this quality assurance maintenance system, rolling as from yesterday. They have gone as far as hiring a qualified engineer who is with them right now and who has devised their QAMS basing on the LTA requirements, LTA guidelines.
The Nesese Bus Company Limited have blamed e-ticketing wirings for the recent spate of bus fires involving their buses. While investigations have found otherwise, Tuna Deva says the company isn't satisfied and have met with e-ticketing service providers, Vodafone and Phonology, to sort the issue out. Roland Koroy, FBC News.
The shortage of nurses in the country isn't a problem, but a challenge that the Health Ministry is working to address. Health Minister Dr. Neil Sharma says their main priority is ensuring good health care for everyone. Shanal Shivan reports.
According to the Health Minister, there is no mass migration of nurses from Fiji, but admits there is still a shortage.
There is no net migration of nurses at this point in time. That has always been, there's been a shortage, and we are trying to meet the needs of our people to provide better nursing care, and there's scope for improving our standards of nursing.
Dr. Neil Sharma says they are doing all they can to meet the needs of all Fijians.
As far as I know, that there's 2,200 nurses on board now, from the figure of 1,600 in 2009. And that literally everybody who is fit has been re-engaged. And we are taking in the nurses who are graduating.
Dr. Sharma says the health ministry will be taking in 200 fresh graduates from 2014. In previous years, they had been taking only 170 graduates.
Dr. Neil Sharma also says that nurses who return from overseas, provide a clearance and are medically fit, will be engaged into the nursing system. Chanel Shivan, FBC News.
It's a huge relief to five villages in Rewa as they carry on with their farms without worrying about flooding problems and sea level rise. This is after the opening of a floodgate in Nandoi village. Epeli Tukuwasa reports.
The newly constructed floodgate will benefit more than 800 people from Lomankoro village to Wunuku, and in particular Nandoi villages, who are usually the worst affected during floods.
We are really happy about this new floodgate because it will stop water overflowing into our village. Now we know that our village is safe if there is any flood.
Villagers are now able to extend their farms and not worry about overflow of water during floods, and also seawater reaching inland to their farms, destroying their crops. The problems of seawater destroying their farms has existed since the time of their forefathers, which is a major obstacle to agriculture work in the area.
Every time there is a flood, the whole area is usually covered with water from here to Wunuku, destroying our crop. This is something our forefathers had been crying for in the past.
Prime Minister Vorenge Mwenimarama says the construction of floodgates is an important part of government strategy in addressing flooding problems and combating the adverse effects of climate change on low-lying areas in Fiji.
This is a major government strategy in reducing the effect of floods. This is also in line with the recent meeting in Nandi on climate change. I hope that this floodgate will bring good things and blessings to the people.
The Nandoi floodgates cost government more than $150,000, and the construction work was carried out by military engineers. Epeli Tukuwasa, FBC News.
The 2.7% economic growth forecasted by the Prime Minister in his 2013 budget address is more realistic, says economist Professor Biman Prasad. His comments come as the Reserve Bank of Fiji revised the economic growth forecast for this year to 3.2%, the highest since 2004. Ritika Pratap reports.
The economic growth projection has been revised because of growing optimism in the economy. Professor Biman Prasad says the country's two main export sectors, sugar and tourism, have not performed well.
Vista arrivals in the first quarter were not as good as what it might be in the second or third quarter, and I think we still have to wait and see. The projections for the increase in sugarcane production by 20% and sugar production by 30%, in my view, is too optimistic.
The RBF says strong growth has been recorded in various partial indicators such as tax collections, remittances, domestic cement sales, and borrowing by the private sector for consumption and investment. Professor Prasad says people are spending more as a result of reduced income tax, but it's not enough.
I think we need to look at the performances in the real sector like agriculture, sugar, and what's happened in the tourism sector in the first quarter. I think we will have to wait until we really assess what has happened in the second quarter and possibly what would happen in the third quarter.
Professor Prasad calls for a more realistic growth projection.
As I said, I think the Prime Minister's forecast in his 2013 budget, in my view, remains realistic. Which is 2.7%, and given what's happening in the real sector, in the sugar industry, in the culture sector, in the manufacturing sector, And given the quality of investments that we might have had, you know, in the last 18 months, it is too optimistic and too early to announce a revised growth forecast of 3.2%.
The RBF says based on the performances of companies, they expect better than anticipated production this year. Therefore, revising the GDP from 25% to 28%. A study by International Monetary Fund shows Fiji's economy will grow by 3%. Ritika Pratap, FBC News.
Still to come on FBC News, coconut juice to hit international market.
You can join us on The Breakfast Show
every weekday from Monday to Friday, 6 a.m. till 9 a.m. right here on Today FM.
That's right.
Nay was sitting on the Neva Katara, Vogabin Benata.
Bula, where was Salavilawa? Dova the Kayo Mena Viva Kinatinikarona Kaloka and a single lady Monitikin of Rombuka, Kakoni Valatana, Nomusini Sari, Nakaisa Maria Dololoma, Lenya Vanini now, Ongorike, the Mena Viva Kinatinikarona Kaloka and a single lady Monitikin of Rombuka and a Bula FM, number 2 and Sere.
Welcome back to FBC News. One of the biggest projects soon to get underway at the Singatoka District Hospital is a new maternity ward. The Coral Coast chapter of the Fiji Islands Hotel and Tourism Association is contributing to this, giving back to the community. Akusita Tale with more.
Construction is expected to begin in the next few months, a major boost for maternal health and baby care in Singatoka. Hotels have already collected $350,000.
Government's come up with over $1 million, so as joint partners on this project, you know, it's quite exciting. You know, it's just required. You know, we need this facility for the women of the Nandrongo Navosa.
The new maternity ward is likely to cost over $2 million and should be up and running in about a year. For hotels based in the Coral Coast, this is a way of showing that they too are a part of Fiji.
When you come to Fiji to manage these resorts, it's beholden that you also get involved in the community, and we do that through our own resort but also with the Hotel Association.
Campaigns such as the No Plastic, That's Fantastic have been a success, and the association is also involved in other community projects. Hopgood says at the end of the day, they want to make a positive impact while also attracting tourists to Fiji. Akusita Tale, FBC News.
Coconut juice could soon be packed and sold overseas as a natural drink. Ezepeli Tukuwasa reports the Agriculture Ministry is looking into the logistics of the project.
The coconut industry would virtually take off overnight if the project gets off the ground.
This coconut juice is promising. It will be for the Viti Levy project, especially on the tourism industry that will take up this coconut juice.
Marcel Salu says packaging coconut juice will take the industry to another level, and the campaign to plant 1 million coconut trees is in preparation for this.
There's a viable market for this coconut juice, but it's in the process. I think they're doing the ground logistics of how to produce and who will be the producers for this juice.
Coconuts are one of the most readily available commodities in Fiji. If everything goes according to plan, freshly pared coconut juice could adorn supermarket shelves in the near future. The product would even be beneficial to the tourism industry. For farmers, it will mean more in their pocket. Epeli Tukuwasa, FBC News.
Fiji Broadcasting Corporation stage at the Vodafone Fiji Hibiscus Festival was a hit last night, with thousands turning up for a night of fun and entertainment. It was Radio Fiji One Night last night, and the main attraction was the Buininga competition. Fans got to mingle with their favorite radio personalities, and station program director Apukukiwanga says they couldn't have asked for a better turnout. Beginning tomorrow, there will be entertainment from FBC's remaining 5 radio stations every night until Friday.
We are really happy with the turnout. It means that people are listening to us and people are watching FBC TV, where we are promoting this night. So they can come here, they can just sit down, relax. They don't have to pay any money. It's free. And all that entertainment here with all the radio personalities and TV personalities on FBC TV and the 6 stations of FBC.
And sports news ahead, action from the BOG Finals.
Bula, I'm Wame. Join me every weekday from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. on The Center Show with classic hits from the 70s as well as the 80s right here on Gold FM.
Aapki shaadi hone wali hai. Paanch paanch bachche honge.
Paanch paanch?
Paanch paanch.
हाय मैं हूँ आपकी सहेली रेनु. सुनते रहिए मिर्च FM. मैं हूँ ना 9 से 12 बजे तक.
Bar has claimed back-to-back wins in the Ink Mobile Battle of the Giants after ousting Lotoka 3-1. Despite Lotoka taking the lead in the first spell, Bar came out strong and scored 3 goals in reply to successfully defend the BOG title. Here are the goals.
Run for Alvin Avinash. Alvin lines up a shot and in it comes, a good one! Cut away by Chosavata Nemboli. Cleared away by Alvin, not a good one. Avinash Swami turns and plays a long through pass, looking for Osea Vakatalasau, but the ball skids into the path as Sorlo, like a defender, he loses his footing. And still Osea Vakatalasau. Vakatalasau races away into the box. Still Vakatalasau laying it on to Ronil. And Ronil, the mistake by Johnny Sorlo. Tries to cut it in. Osea wins it. Still Osea Vakatalasau takes it to the byline, comes in with a shot, tapped away by Sorolo, and then following through is Avinaswamy. And then Lysenia Rora just floats it back into the Lotoka territory. Play centered on the far side as it comes kindly for Osea. Osea lets it run and gets a 1-2. Osea Vakatalasau, and Osea Vakatalasau in the 35th minute of play.
Well, there has been lively football action on the field during the Ink Mobile Battle of the Giants. Some important decisions were made in a council meeting yesterday. Fiji Football Association is very serious about getting Fiji a better ranking and international exposure. Shelvin Chant has more.
Development of young players has been neglected for too long. The council has decided to set up national age grade development squads.
The under-20 build-up for the 2015 World Cup in New Zealand, where we got a chance to qualify as the other qualifying nation from the Oceania, is New Zealand will have an automatic qualification. And this is positive that the Southern Under-20 squad will be assembled and the Western Under-20 squad.
Fiji currently ranks 187 out of 207 countries on FIFA standings.
Good level-head thinking from the districts now that, yes, it's about time that Fiji, FA, people are talking about ranking and everything, what the districts are doing to help the national body. And this is something that now they have come up with.
Overseas players will not feature for district sides anymore as well. Fiji FA says the decision to get overseas players was initially made to attract big names.
Now the days are over for the foreign players, where we used to groom players for island nations like Vanuatu or Solomons, and you know, foreign players coming in. Our main duty was for foreign players when we had proposed this was players like, you know, Ronaldinho or players like Thierry Henry, which is retired and would like to come and apply their trade here. For that was the reason. So if districts could afford it, they should bring players like that.
The decisions made in the council meeting has been welcomed by all districts and hopes are high that this will help Fiji soccer. Shalvin Chand, FBC Sports.
The Fiji Sevens team moved into camp over the weekend as they have 2 weeks to get ready for the Pacific mini games. While many would have thought this would be National Sevens coach Ali Ferretindere's final hurrah, but it seems this is not the case. Shelvin Chant has more.
Coach Ali Ferretindere initially said he would not apply, but now there seems to be a change of heart. Even more, it seems that the application deadline was also extended.
No regrets, so they've extended the post for applying, so friends has been asking me to reapply for this post.
So you'll be reapplying?
So I am reapplying.
In the last 2 years, the Fiji Sevens team have managed to win the Hong Kong Sevens twice, but have barely threatened New Zealand's dominance in the Sevens series.
Mazuni is a coach for the past two seasons, and I'm quite happy about it. There's a lot of challenges, and I've got a lot of things learned from the last two seasons.
Ndere is now working with a young team and is confident of a gold medal haul from Wallis and Futuna.
Giving us tough competitions, and as we look at our record in the Pacific Games, so the last one we've came third. So for this one, and we'll try and better that one.
It could be plain sailing for Fiji in the mini games, with only Samoa providing the real threat. But as the saying goes, don't count your chicks before they hatch. Shelvin Chand, FBC Sports.
Milika Tuivanwavo is a sure medal prospect at the Pacific Mini Games. The former heptathlete will be leading the charge in the throwing and jumping events. The 23-year-old will also be looked upon for guidance by her younger team members. Shelvin Chand again.
Milika Tuivanwavo is back after her stint in Fresno, United States. She believes she is a better athlete now.
Really good eye-opener, just a taste of what it's like internationally. Really enjoyed myself, grown in so many ways, and just excited to compete in the mini games again.
The athlete has been doing Fiji proud from a very young age. After 2 years of competing in the heptathlon, Milika believes her true calling is in the jumps and throwing events.
Heptathlon, wow. My first one was in my first ever mini games in Palau. That was a lot of fun. It was tough. Tried to continue with that. I did another 2 years of that, and didn't really work out for me. but I would say I have a lot of respect for all the heptathletes out there and what they put their bodies through.
Milika will compete in the hammer throw. According to Athletics Fiji, she has been trained by a former Olympic coach.
I threw it a couple of times in the States, just practicing. We needed points for the team, so I volunteered, and it went really well. It's different. It's nothing that I've ever done before, but still a lot of fun.
The athletics team to Wallis and Futuna is made up of 25 members, but each athlete has depth and the ability to get multiple medals. Shelvin Chan, FBC Sports.
Taekwondo Fiji hasn't lost focus of the target that they have set for themselves at the Pacific Mini Games. All steps are being taken to get the gold that has been eluding them for some time. Shelvin Chand reports.
The Taekwondo team to the Pacific Mini Games has probably been training longer than any other team going to Wallis and Futuna.
They're all good, they're all fit, medically all good, no injuries so far. We are now just focusing ourselves on the technicals of the competition, setting out keywords, techniques on where to score, what not to do, planning our matches, and those things.
The athletes in this team believe that one will only get stronger if they compete against tougher opposition.
Now with these guys and the Koreans helping us, I can see a big change in not only techniques but the attitude of the athletes as well. And we're going to give them a good go over there.
A match against the Kiribati outfit fell through. This would have provided a chance for coaches to gauge the athletes.
It didn't. Unfortunately, Kiribati was supposed to come in and give us a go before we left for the mini games. That didn't happen. However, that has still not dampened our spirits. The guys from Korea has been instrumental in getting our team up to par. And the athletes have been actually competing with these guys from Korea, so they've got their confidence levels up as well.
Taekwondo's last glory at a regional meet was at the Pacific Games in 2011, where the team came back with a silver medal. They reckon it's time for gold. Shelvin Chan, FBC Sports.
With the exception of Savu Savu, fine weather was experienced all over. Bar was the hottest at 31 degrees at 4 this afternoon. The fine weather is expected to continue for most centres tomorrow. Unfortunately for the capital, let's hope the typical hibiscus weather isn't back. Showers are expected for Suva and Sabu Sabu. This same weather pattern is expected to continue throughout the week. The headlines again, Bar retains BOG title. 15 necessary buses allowed back on the road. And floodgates to reduce threats of flooding for villages in Rewa. To the poll question now. Who should be held responsible for the latest rugby protest? FRU, unions or teachers? Visit our FBC website to take part. Remember to send us newsworthy pictures and videos. Email citizenseyes@fbc.com.fj. Keep safe, especially if you're visiting the Hibiscus Grounds. Till next weekend, Mother Mother.
Nimbula, medango nimilote na isaro tumboa. Nama kia umina rua kina ona na vya kavi moniti kina vaka rombuka. Rongo mena vya sama kina viva kwa baro takini ndreko malolo. Eno Radio Fiji One na wongani vya unyano. Ngai nama kia ukina.
Jahan ho pyar ka basera. Aur rishto ki khushbu. Wohi aapka apna ghar sansar. Join me on Ghar Sansar. Monday to Friday, 9 a.m. till 12 p.m. Only on Radio Fiji 2.